Hello dear students, this is Ritu Jindal from SDKL JAV Centenary Senior Secondary Public School Mansa, Punjab. Today we will discuss the principles of Henry Fayol, principle of division of work, principle of authority and responsibility, and principle of discipline, plus two business studies. Now dear student, let's start the topic. Henry Fayol actually was the engineer, mining engineering in 1860, and started working as an engineer in a coal mining company. In 1988, he was promoted as a managing director of the company. And at that time, the company was in the situation of insolvency. He accepted so many challenges and has applied his managerial technique and to bring out the company from the situation, and he succeeded. At the time of retirement, the company was a leading coal steel company with strong financial background. Dear student, the person who brought the company from financial crisis to number one position, actually he was an engineer. But at the time of doing managing job, he was facing so many challenges, so many bad situations he has to face. But with his skill, with his managerial technique, he has made some rules, some guidelines for the management, and due to this, he is known as the father of general management. The contribution of Henry Fayol towards the management is 14 principles of management and 5 functions of management, which we have earlier discussed in first chapter: planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling. These functions are given by the Henry Fayol. Similarly, 14 principles of management guidelines are given by the Henry Fayol, and he designed these guidelines with his experiments, with his observation, which is very beneficial or useful for a manager during his managing job. So now let's start the contribution of Henry Fayol. The 14 principles given by the dwelt by the Henry Fayol are: division of work, authority and responsibility, principle of discipline, principle of command, unity of direction, subordination of individual interest to general interest, fair remuneration to persons, centralization and decentralization, principle of scalar chain, principle of order, principle of equity, stability in the tenure, principle of initiative, and asperity crop. Out of these, today we will discuss first 3 principles: division of work, authority and responsibility, principle of discipline. Now let's start the first principle, division of work. Principle of division of work, as the name suggests, divide the work to be done by the employees in the organization. Agar ek hi person har kaam, suppose for example students, furniture making company hai, ek hi person aapne 50 chairs banane hai, 5 employees hai aapke paas, aur aapne 5 ko keh diya ki 10 chairs banao, it will be difficult. Agar aap isko aise divide karo कि फर्स्ट बंदे ने सिर्फ कटिंग करनी है, सेकेंड पर्सन हैज टू गिव द शेप, थर्ड पर्सन हैज टू मेक द पॉलिश, व्हाट विल बी द इफेक्ट? जो पर्सन बार बार कटिंग कर रहा है, ही विल बी यूज्ड टू, ही विल बी स्पेशलाइज्ड इन दैट वर्क. जो पर्सन बार बार पॉलिश कर रहा है, ही विल बी स्पेशलाइज्ड इन दैट वर्क. इन केस ऑफ बैंक्स आल्सो, कैश लोन डिपार्टमेंट अलग है, कैश डिपार्टमेंट अलग है, एंड डिफरेंट डिफरेंट डिपार्टमेंट्स आर देयर. जो पर्सन बार बार कॉन्टिन्यूसली, द पर्सन विल डू द सेम वर्क, ही विल बी स्पेशलाइज्ड इन दैट वर्क, एंड व्हाट विल बी द रिजल्ट? एफिशिएंसी एंड इफेक्टिवनेस विल बी इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस वर्क. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस द प्रिंसिपल, द होल वर्क मस्ट बी डिवाइडेड इनटू द स्मॉल टास्क, एंड इंस्टेड ऑफ असाइनिंग द होल वर्क टू वन पर्सन ओनली, one task of work should be assigned to one person. Ek jaisa kaam ek person ko do, according to his capability, his qualification, and his experience. When a person will perform a part of job again and again, he will be perfect and specialized in doing that job, and the result is the efficiency level of that person will improve. उसी काम को आप बार 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 कॉन्टिन्यूसली करते जा रहे हो, लीड्स टू स्पेशलाइजेशन, व्हेनेवर देयर विल बी द स्पेशलाइजेशन, टाइम भी कम हो जाएगा आपको. फर्स्ट सपोज आप पहले दिन सेम वर्क कर रहे हो, 10 मिनट्स लगे, फिर 7, फिर 6, फिर 5, कम होते जाएंगे बिकॉज यू विल बी एक्सपर्ट इन दैट वर्क. अकॉर्डिंग टू फ्योर द प्रिंस दैट वर्क शुड बी डिवाइडेड बिटवीन द पर्सन्स. नाउ नेक्स्ट, फ्योर सेड दैट नॉट ओनली द प्रोडक्शन वर्क, जरूरी नहीं है कि सिर्फ प्रोडक्शन वर्क डिवाइड हो, यू कैन डिवाइड द टेक्निकल, मैनेजीरियल एंड स्किल्स जॉब विल बी डिवाइडेड बिटवीन द पर्सन्स. It helps the individuals in acquiring speed, accuracy in his performance. No doubt, speed will increase, accuracy will also increase. Specialization leads to efficiency and economy in sphere of business. By this principle, human resource can be used in a better way. You can make the use of better use of human power because wastage nahi hogi, same banda same work kar raha hai, the interest will be created, efficiency level will be created. Productivity will be created. So the positive and consequences of violation of this principle are, if a manager will follow the principle of division of work, then positive effects are, specialization will be there. Person will become the specialized in his or her field. It improves the efficiency level also of the employees. And consequences of violation means, if we not follow this principle, then what will be the negative effect? There will not be specialization and there will be not be efficiency level, increasing efficiency level. Now next is principle of authority and responsibility. Authority means powers to take the decision. Responsibility means obligation to complete the work. Now Fayol said, a person should have the equal responsibilities and powers. Dono cheeze match honi zaruri hai. Suppose aapke paas powers bahut zyada hai lekin responsibility nahi hai, that will result into the misuse of power. Ki haan mere paas power to hai, responsible to hu nahi kisi cheez ke liye. Second alternate, you have the more responsibilities, kaam ki tension, kaam ka workload, responsibility bahut zyada, but no matching authority is there, it results into the frustration among the employees. So there should be a balance or parity between authority and responsibility, both should be equal. Authority means powers to take the decisions, responsibility means obligation to complete the job assigned on time. According to this principle, there must be a balance between the authority and responsibility. Excess of authority without matching responsibility may bring negative results, misuse of powers. An excess of responsibility without matching authority will not allow the worker to complete the job because will be frustrated. There is need to bring parity, balance between both for the best result. It increases confidence of the employees. It will increase the confidence level of the employee. Now next, positive effects and consequences. According to Fayol, authority minus authority, responsibility, irresponsible behavior, and responsibility minus authority, responsibility is more than authority, is ineffective. There should be parity between, both should be equal. Positive effects, no misuse of authority. Agar responsibility or authority barabar hai, powers and obligation barabar hai, to misuse nahi hoga. And helps in meeting the responsibilities on time without delay. Person will meet his responsibility on time. Misuse of authority due to excess authority. Agar aap isko nahi follow karoge, to negative result kya hai? Authority will be misused by the person and delay in work. If responsibility is more than authority, then there will be the delay in work. Now next, principle of discipline. Discipline means general rules and regulations for systematic working in an organization. Discipline doesn't mean only rules and regulation, but it means developing commitment also. There should be commitment in employees towards the organization as well as towards each other, and similarly employers should have the commitments towards the employees. Both the parties should have the commitments towards each other. That is also the part of discipline means. First aspect, rules and regulations for the systematic working. Second point covers under the discipline is commitment from employee side as well as from employer sides. Fuel insists that discipline is required at superior as well as subordinate level. Discipline should be required at both the levels, चाहे वो superiors हैं चाहे वो subordinates हैं. The disciplinary rules shall not be applicable only on subordinate. It should be applied on superior or bosses also. Employees will obey orders only when management play their part by providing good leadership. Means both the parties should be responsible. Employees तभी obey करेंगे अगर management अच्छी leader होगी. So management should have the commitments as well as employees should have the commitment. अगर दोनों अपने commitment पूरे करेंगे फिर business चलेगा फिर organization चलेगी. Now next, sincerity, obediency, respect of authority and observation of rules and regulation of the enterprise is also the part of discipline. Subordinates should respect their superiors and obey their orders. Smooth running of enterprises. Discipline can be enforced if good superiors at every level. Clear and fair agreement with the workers should be there. Judicious application of penalty, that is also the part of principle of discipline, means there may be the penalty from both the sides, meeting the commitment from both parties, superior as well as subordinate. Now next, if we follow, then what will be the positive effect? If we not follow, then what will be the consequences? Positive effects of principle of discipline. Systematic working, it improves the efficiency level. And if we will not follow this principle, then what will be the effect? Principle disorder in the organization, confusion, chores, wastage of resources, and the absence of discipline. No fulfillment of work as no commitment is there. So these are the principle of authority and responsibility, principle of division of work, principle of discipline. Out of 14 principles, these are the three principles given by Henry Fuel. Now, dear students, that is all about the today's session. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.